Food Safety Modernization Act, or FSMA, is the first major overhaul of the U.S. food safety system since 1938. Even though our food system is generally very safe, continual foodborne illness outbreaks prompted consumers to push for updates to our nation's food safety systems. And so in 2011, FSMA was signed into law, with a stronger focus on preventing outbreaks instead of responding after people are already sick. The federal law is administered by the Food and Drug Administration. In Minnesota, the State Department of Agriculture implements and enforces the rule. FSMA is much broader than fresh produce. It has seven sections or rules that focus on different aspects of the food system. One of these, the Produce Safety Rule, will apply to some Minnesota farms. The rule sets, for the first time, science-based standards to support food safety on produce farms. Of course, all farms should use good agricultural practices for food safety. The Produce Safety Rule regulations include a lot of flexibility, and you might be fully covered, qualified exempt, or not covered, depending on your farm size and what you grow. Let's walk through basic exemptions of the rule so you know how the rule applies to you and your farm. Here are four types of products that are not covered by the Produce Safety Rule. Any produce that is grown for personal or on-farm consumption is not covered by the rule. Next, these 34 produce items are not covered by the rule because the FDA defines them as rarely consumed raw. Food grains are also not covered because they are not considered produce. Finally, any produce that will be commercially processed in a way that kills pathogens is also eligible for an exemption. For example, tomatoes grown for paste can be eligible for an exemption because they will be processed in a way that kills pathogens. You will eventually need to keep certain records related to processing to maintain this exemption. Let's move on and look at how farms are covered under the Produce Safety Rule. Your farm will fall into one of three categories under the Produce Safety Rule. Your farm is either not covered, qualified exempt, or fully covered by the rule. It all depends on your annual sales and who buys your food. Just a note, all dollar amounts here are based on 2011 figures and are adjusted for inflation each year. You can find current figures on the FDA website. In order to determine if the Produce Safety Rule applies to your farm, you'll first need to look at whether your average annual produce sales are more than $25,000. If the answer is no, your farm is not covered by the Produce Safety Rule. Keep in mind, all produce sales count, including produce that will be processed with a kill step or is rarely consumed raw. If you sell more than $25,000 in produce each year, your farm will be either qualified exempt or fully covered. It depends on your farm's average annual food sales and who your buyers are. If your farm's average annual food sales are less than $500,000 and you sell the majority of your food to qualified end users, then your farm is qualified exempt. How is food defined in the Produce Safety Rule? Food is anything that will be eaten by humans or animals. All produce, other food crops, livestock, and value-added products sold by your farm. This doesn't necessarily mean all these items are covered by the Produce Safety Rule. They just have to be figured into your average annual sales here. What is a qualified end user? A qualified end user is the consumer of the food, such as a customer at a farmer's market or CSA, or a retail food establishment, such as a restaurant or grocery store. If the majority of your sales go to these buyers, your farm is qualified exempt, and you will not need to comply with most of the Produce Safety Rule. Finally, your farm might be fully covered by the Produce Safety Rule. If your average annual food sales are more than $500,000, your farm is fully covered by the rule. If your average annual food sales are less than $500,000, but the majority of your buyers are non-qualified end users, your farm is also fully covered. What is a non-qualified end user? Non-qualified end users include most wholesale distributors and some food hubs that buy and resell produce. If your farm is fully covered by the Produce Safety Rule, the next step is to send at least one representative from the farm to a Produce Safety Rule grower training. At the day-long training, you will learn the specifics of what a covered farm must do to be in compliance with the Produce Safety Rule. These trainings are led by Minnesota Department of Agriculture staff, University of Minnesota Extension staff, and farmer trainers. All farms are welcome to attend these low-cost courses to learn more about the Produce Safety Rule. Even if you are not covered, you can get valuable information about produce safety from these courses. If your farm is qualified exempt, you'll need to keep annual sales records to demonstrate that you qualify for the exemption. And you'll need to display the complete business address of the farm where the produce was grown on packaging labels, invoices, or signage at the point of sale. If your farm is not covered, there's nothing more you need to do under the Produce Safety Rule. Of course, whether covered by the rule or not, all farms should use good agricultural practices for food safety. University of Minnesota Extension and the Minnesota Department of Agriculture want to help you succeed in producing safe, healthy vegetables and fruits for your customers. Check out the links in the description to learn more.